unfortunately, it's almost a total body insult. So the consequences are far-reaching when we have hypertension. Well, what causes it? Now, when I put this figure on the side, I didn't realize until we loaded it that it rotates and that the light bulb blinks off and on. So you may not want to just concentrate on that particular figure. It may or may not make you dizzy. But I chose that figure. I'm going to talk a little bit about what's important about this. In order to find the cause of hypertension, it takes a village sometimes. It takes not only the individual, but their physician or their medical provider. And often, in order to make a good diagnosis, it takes multiple specialists working in concert with the primary care physician and the patient. So it takes a number of individuals often to help come up with the idea that's necessary. I put aging here. Unfortunately, aging is one of the factors that cause hypertension that we cannot control. Haven't found a youth yet or a pill to stop the aging process ever. But if we start talking about treatment, there are some things that as we get older, if we do and pay attention to, we can actually decrease the chance of hypertension or help treat it. But aging causes a stiffening, if you will, or an inflexibility in the body. Ever try to get up from one of these conferences after an hour or so? You know how you feel? Well, this is part of the aging process, and it actually happens to the blood vessels. And the arteries just get stiffer as we get older. You might use the metaphor of a garden hose. Brand new garden hose from Lowe's. Love those things, don't you? Nice and green or black, and they're just, I mean, you can twist them, right? Twist them, turn them, and wrap them in knots, and they just keep on going. So you leave it outside, it rains on it, and it snows on it, and it frosts on it, and then after about a year or so, you decide to tighten a knot. And what happens? It's very stiff, and it sometimes will just break, right? Well, this is kind of like the blood vessels. So there is this with aging. Smoking is a significant cause of hypertension and can complicate hypertension and its consequences on the body. Actually, the nicotine serves as a compressor, if you will, of arteries. It can cause arterial spasm. Therefore, the blood can't get through as well. Therefore, the pressure has to increase. Remember, we talked about that early on. So it can make a big difference in what happens. Actually, just one cigarette causes a spasm, that is, spasm of the vessels, for up to several days. So it's very powerful. Nicotine is a very powerful and potent agent. Diabetes, as I had mentioned before, can cause difficulties as well within the blood vessels themselves. Many times it can cause problems with increased deposition of materials within the arterial walls, which causes the narrowing of the vessel. The more narrow the vessel, the higher the head of pressure needed to get the blood through to the body. So diabetes has its own cardiovascular disease risk, all its own. That's why we said earlier, if someone has diabetes, then we have to look at a lower level for problems with their. Obesity often is its own primary problem. Many people can solve their problems with hypertension just by losing weight. This has a varied reasons for this, including, unfortunately, as we increase our weight, often our lipids increase, the blood fats, including our cholesterol, the good and the bad. Unfortunately, more the bad. And when that happens, we know that there is more deposition of cholesterol material and fatty materials within the lining of the arteries. So what we find is when we start losing weight, even for every 5 pounds, we get a reduction in our blood pressure. We need to lose weight. We don't have to lose it all to get a plus with our blood pressure. Actually, every 5 pounds makes a difference. Drugs were brought up earlier as a possible reason for our blood pressure to go up, and it's true. Not only those drugs that we take for colds that have decongestants can certainly drive our blood pressure up, but street drugs, illicit drugs, cocaine, heroin, PCP, some of the pain-relieving medications, Oxycontin, codeine. Many of these drugs can actually drive the pressure up. Sleep apnea. What happens with sleep apnea, as you know, condition where often it's called sleep apnea, means fall into a very deep sleep. Sometimes neck starts to relax and our tongue falls back into our throat and we snore. But what happens is we're not getting that flow of oxygen that we normally would. And so we have periods where the brain doesn't get the message, you need to breathe. And so there will be short times where maybe for just a few seconds, the individual does not breathe at night or whenever they're asleep. If this continues over time, it can put tremendous pressure on the heart. And then that can put pressure on the lungs. And then we can certainly get hypertension from that. The renal and the renovascular abnormalities include any kind of kidney disease. If a person has a primary kidney problem, develop hypertension. If you have the arteries leading to the kidneys begin to narrow, then that can cause hypertension as well, because the kidneys are so intimately involved with secreting chemicals that keep our blood pressure either higher or lower and regulate our blood pressure in general. Endocrine abnormalities include any of the hormone problems, thyroid disease, particularly hyperthyroidism, when the thyroid is too high, can lead to hypertension, can also have problems with our adrenal glands, too much cortisone secreted or cortisol by our body secreted can cause hypertension. And physical have to be considered. There are certain abnormalities that are congenital, that is, they have occurred before birth and actually may not have been recognized, may be mild enough not to be recognized early on, but can lead to hypertension. White coats, very important cause of inaccurately diagnosed hypertension. When, I don't know how many of your primary care providers wear a white coat anymore. I never used to do it in the office, but the whole idea is whether they have a white coat on or not, you know you're going to the doctor. You know that they're going to weigh you, ow, for me, particularly, and then they're going to take your blood pressure, maybe another ow. So what happens is we already start to build up our concern about these things, and that can actually